In today's video, I will explain myocarditis. I'm going to talk about myocarditis causes, signs, and symptoms, and explain myocarditis and pericarditis diet, and other natural treatments. If you're new to my YouTube channel, my name is Greta, and I'm an online nutritionist and a holistic health coach. If you haven't yet, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Why is it important to talk about myocarditis? Well, recently, myocarditis and pericarditis cases have exploded. Probably we all know why. I'm not allowed to talk about this. It went from being extremely rare, with most doctors reporting that they have never seen any myocarditis cases in their entire careers, or maybe just a few cases, to now seeing high numbers of myocarditis and pericarditis cases. Those under 30 are at the greatest risk for developing myocarditis or pericarditis, and it affects males more often than females. We will often hear, "It's nothing to worry about, it's mild, myocarditis is not a serious health condition." Well, the truth is that there's no such thing as mild myocarditis. Myocarditis is inflammation of the heart. To be more specific, it's inflammation of myocardium, which is a heart muscle. What is pericarditis? Pericarditis is inflammation of the pericardium, the inflammation of the outer lining of the heart. So both of these conditions are very similar, and they often occur together. It's inflammation of the heart. However, myocarditis is associated with more serious long-term health consequences than pericarditis. Inflammation in the myocardium layer causes swelling, which can affect the heart muscle's ability to contract. That means that less blood would get pumped out of the heart with each heartbeat. After the inflammation ends, the heart contractions should come back to normal. However, in severe cases, it can't come back to normal. Severe inflammation of the heart can create scar tissue in the myocardium. This scar tissue is not the same as healthy heart tissue, and it cannot contract normally. When it happens, you get permanent damage of the heart. It cannot regenerate. In severe myocarditis cases, you might end up with a heart failure, which means that the heart can't keep up with the body's demands. In some cases, you might even need a heart transplant. It is a serious health condition. Does it affect your life expectancy? The life expectancy of myocarditis patients depends on its severity. Mild cases end in a few days, with or without treatment. In this case, the life expectancy shouldn't be affected too much, while you still have increased risk of heart problems in the future. However, severe myocarditis can surely reduce life expectancy. Severe myocarditis can cause blood clots, which lead to stroke, heart attacks. It may also cause heart failure and sudden death. So it is very important to do all what's possible to reduce this inflammation and decrease the damage as much as possible. How long does myocarditis last? In healthy young adults with myocarditis, symptoms can go away after a couple of weeks. In other milder cases, it might take a few months to recover. In more severe cases, the damage of the heart muscle can be permanent, as mentioned earlier. Now, what causes myocarditis? Causes may vary from infections, inflammatory conditions, to exposure to toxic agents. There are many possible causes of myocarditis, including bacteria or viruses, or it can also be an autoimmune disease, where your own immune system attacks your heart. Or it could be caused as a result of your immune system overreacting to bacterial or viral infections. What are the signs and symptoms of myocarditis? It might have no symptoms at all. You could have myocarditis and not even know about it. For those who do have symptoms, the most common ones include shortness of breath during physical activity or while resting, or while trying to fall asleep. Rapid or abnormal heartbeats, which is called arrhythmias, lightheadedness, a static or tightening chest pain or pressure in the chest, fluid buildup with swelling on your legs, ankles, and feet, feeling tired. In cases when myocarditis is caused by a virus, other signs and symptoms of a viral infection, such as headache, body aches, joint pain, fever, and a sore throat or diarrhea could occur. In some cases, myocarditis symptoms may be similar to those of a heart attack. If you experience unexplained chest pain and shortness of breath, you should seek emergency help. What are the symptoms of pericarditis? Very similar. Chest pain that feels like a stabbing sensation. You could also have pain in the neck, fever, nausea, lightheadedness, and a sudden shortness of breath. And something unique about pericarditis is that the pain can get worse when laying down and better when leaning forward. What are the regular treatments for myocarditis? It depends on the cause and severity of your myocarditis, but as a general rule, bed rest is usually recommended. Any exercise should be avoided for 6 months. It's important to not put extra pressure on the heart muscle and let it heal. Painkillers are often recommended to deal with chest pain. Medications such as ACE inhibitors, beta blockers, and diuretics are commonly used. Now, what else can you do to reduce heart inflammation and reduce damage caused by myocarditis or pericarditis? First, it is very important to remove any possible sources of inflammation. This includes any ultra-processed foods that contain refined vegetable oils, sugar, artificial sweeteners, genetically modified foods, and any harmful food additives like MSG or monosodium glutamate. This means no fast food, no takeaways, no crisps, no sugary drinks, and no alcohol. Also, I would recommend to reduce any sugary or starchy foods in general, as they promote inflammation. If possible, replace starchy foods like pasta, bread, and rice with extra vegetables. If you have any grain products, have smaller amounts and eat only ancient grains like quinoa, black rice, and red rice. Eat foods that lower inflammation and help your body to heal. Foods like berries, nuts, seeds, herbs, small wild fish like sardines or anchovies, healthy fats such as extra virgin olive oil and extra virgin coconut oil. Any type of vegetables and fruits, including spinach, rocket, kale, tomatoes, peppers, avocados, healthy protein sources such as organic grass-fed meat. Make sure you get loads of different vitamins, minerals, antioxidants, and phytonutrients from colorful foods. It will help you to heal faster. In addition, have some fermented foods like yogurt, kefir, or kombucha. You could also have bone broth. It's a soup made by boiling bones for a long time. It has various compounds needed for healing. You can Google how to make bone broth or simply order bone broth concentrate on Amazon. I will leave a link to useful supplements in the description of this video. And after watching this video, you can watch my other video explaining what to eat for faster recovery. It will appear on the screen at the end of this video. One really useful supplement for myocarditis and any type of heart inflammation is L-carnitine. L-carnitine is important for heart and brain function, muscle movement, and many other body processes. It is used for chest pain, myocarditis, and heart failure. Are there any other natural treatments available? Yes, you should look into hyperbaric oxygen therapy. What's that? Hyperbaric oxygen treatment involves giving the body extra oxygen. A hyper means increased, and baric relates to pressure. Oxygen makes around 21% of the air we breathe. During hyperbaric oxygen procedure, you breathe 100% pure oxygen under increased pressure. Hyperbaric oxygen therapy can improve myocardial blood perfusion. Perfusion is the process of oxygenated blood being delivered to the tissues of the body, reduce inflammation and vascular endothelial dysfunction. So it is a really promising therapy. If you would like to find a clinic that does hyperbaric oxygen therapy, simply type hyperbaric oxygen therapy and your city name or your country name and see if it's available where you are. So, I don't want you to panic. Focus on good rest. Eat good food, all the colors you can. Avoid toxic foods. Avoid physical activity for now. Maybe have only some light walks. Breathe some fresh air daily. Have some sunlight. In addition, you can do hyperbaric oxygen therapy, take L-carnitine, and drink bone broth. And I wish you a quick recovery. If you found this video useful, like it and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.